Please welcome Anthony LaPaglia. We will get to this wonderful classic
play. What's going on with you? You haven't aged. I've aged like 95 years, and you haven't aged 1 year since the last time I was here. What are you drinking? Come
on. He's on the Botox.
He's on the Botox.
No. You know what they say. If you're black, you don't crack.
Listen, I'm part Sicilian. It's not true.
Go on. Right. Maybe full Sicilian, different story. We'll talk about this play. Classic. Incredible play. But how is it possible that an actor of your status and experience has never done theatre in Australia?
I really don't have the answer. I mean, I didn't start here as an actor. I mean, right. I tried to start here, but that's an old story. It didn't quite work, so I went to America, and it worked. It only took 8 years, 9 years of trying, but... I was offered things here, but the thing with Australian theatre has always been they needed such a huge time commitment from you.
Right.
Like, you had to commit 6 months in advance, and then you were... And financially, it would just send me bankrupt.
There we go. Yeah. There
we go. But it's true.
We got to the real, like, you know, about brass tacks.
Can I tell you what? Honestly, show business is called show business for a reason.
Well, other than financially, how different is TV and movies to doing theatre?
Theatre is infinitely harder. It's far more work involved to get it right. And you have to go up and fly without a net for 2 hours every night, twice on Wednesday, twice on Saturday. So it's much more challenging. I mean, doing film and TV work is challenging in its own way. Your concentration gets broken a lot doing movies and television. Right. In theatre, at least you get, hopefully, a continuous flow.
Yeah.
That's what you're aiming for.
Yeah.
We'll see if we get there.
You've had your eye on the role of Willie Loman for years, is that right?
Mm-mm.
You hadn't?
No.
Oh, you hadn't been wanting to play
him
for a
long
time?
No, but I've done... I did View from the Bridge for about a year on Broadway, and I've wanted to do, through that collaboration, I got to work with Arthur before he died, and established a kind of amazing, I wouldn't say friendship, but a relationship with him. And what I had wanted to do was a play called After the Fall, which is a different play, and it's more about his relationship with the Un-American Activities Committee that he stood up against and would not spill the beans on to other people, and also his relationship with Marilyn Monroe. Mm. And whenever I would talk to him about it, he would say, that play's not finished. I'm never going to finish it. It's not, don't do it. And that was the play that I had my eye on doing. Mm. And Death of a Salesman, I've had the great pleasure of seeing it done by some amazing people. And sometimes you think, why mess with something that's already so fantastic? Yeah. I remember the last time I saw...
Because you're Anthony LaPaglia, that's why.
No, but there are people that are much better. I saw Brian Dennehy do it on Broadway a few years back now. But he was just an absolute, like, powerhouse. And you see that and you go, you know what? Some people just own that role, let alone. Mm. And I got a call from Neil, the director, who I love. And
couldn't say no.
I absolutely could not say no. Right.
Well, just as well.
Because Neil Armfield, I've always admired his theatre work. I mean, whenever I was in town and there was a play of his on, I would go to see it and I'd always be blown away.
Well, he was clearly blown away with you because, this is to have this role in this play is an enormous honour. So.
Well, thank you.
Thank you for being here.
Thank you so much for having me.
Go to the Salesman in Melbourne. Tickets are available now. Go to our website, Anthony LaPaglia.